Hey everyone, it is I, Jack, and In a Violent Nature, a Shudder original. I'm pretty sure you've already seen other reviews on this, but just want to put my 2 cents in there. In a Violent Nature is technically a horror film from the killer's perspective, and has interesting and different as that is, the real question is it effective? Well, first off, is the film good? I want to say it's fair. It's a fair film. And here's the reason why. When you come at a film and you're using the antagonist perspective and solely sticking to that, you're not building much. You're not building the world. You're just, okay, this person exists and this person does that and that person will lead on to do that, but you're not getting the why. You're not getting really the reasoning why this is happening. And what the film is technically describing itself to be just solely from the killer's perspective, but it breaks its rule because it has to give you a reason. So it does show you a moment where people are around a campfire talking about this urban legend, and also a quick moment where the killer has a memory. So it breaks its own rule to build a little bit of the lore, which you have to do. So, I mean, kudos for attempting something very different. I mean, that's great. But it shows you that it doesn't really work, unfortunately. As gruesome, I mean, if you're going into this film, you're going to see gruesome kills. And that's a fact. Give it top notch for that. Give it awards for that, because it was one kill. Whew, very interesting kind of kill. So give an award for that. But in terms of keeping you engaged, I really didn't. I mean, to be honest, on my TikTok, I put up a video of myself narrating a small scene. Like if it was a BBC Nature documentary. I mean, you're following the killer through the woods. There's nothing but ambient sound. And this is going on for like 5-10 minutes. What else are you supposed to do? I mean, yeah, you're just going to be like watching and okay. Okay, but after a while you kind of get uneasy. You're like, all right, let's move it on. You start to feel those minutes. So for me, the easiest thing was to start narrating the film like if I'm watching a nature documentary. And I know that's not what the producers or directors intended. So, I mean, to me, that shows you that perspective, it doesn't always work. You have to do the give and take in horror films. Unless you're going to really do it from the villain perspective, but have people engaging into that character, with that character, engaging with that character, but also explaining the why. Why does this character have to be this way? That will strike the fear in people. But good attempt. Good attempt. It was interesting. It was interesting. So would I recommend it? Rush to get this. Rush to see it on Shudder. I say get Shudder. That's a great service. I really love Shudder. But would I rush to see this? No, not really. And I'm kind of glad. I'm kind of glad I didn't go to the Alamo Draft House to see this. I wanted to, but other things happened and I couldn't. So I'm glad I didn't go, and I'm glad I saw it on Shudder. But, I mean, hopefully others will take an example of this film and say, you know what, we can maybe do something different with it. But anyways, though, that's just me. Those are my thoughts. How about you? What are your thoughts? Leave a comment below. let me know. Was it awesome to you? Were you hooked from the moment he rises from the dirt? Yeah, leave a comment. And also like, subscribe, and all those other things. And I'll see you in the next one. Cheers.